First of all, welcome Mr. Kaushik Roy to Decode. We're thrilled to have you here today. For those of you joining us for the first time, Decode is a food tech podcast where we speak to leading pioneers in the industry. And speaking of leading pioneers, we have Mr. Kaushik Roy with us today, founder and CEO of the much-loved Biryani by Kilo. I think congratulations are in order for you. 5 years, 50 outlets, 20 cities. I know the IPL is suspended right now, but we're glad to hear of your half century.
Thank you so much. It's a wonderful journey.
Can you walk us through the story of Biryani by Kilo? How did it start for you?
So basically, I come from the food and beverage industry, and I've done around 250 restaurants in my career. And I was opening restaurants for others. And one of my friends once said, ki logo ke liye restaurant khulta kabhi apna bhi khol ke dekh le. I think it started from there. The keeda came in from there. That I saw a huge opportunity in the biryani category. 6 years back, biryani was not a category. That time it was part of the North Indian cuisine. It was part of the Indian menu, North Indian menu or South Indian menu. But biryani was not a category like it is today in Zomato. You could see biryani as a category. So that time I saw this opportunity of biryani being, because it was one wholesome food. First of all, carbs and proteins are there. It is a product that can be delivered. Unlike a pizza burger, you could have it more often because it's desi food. So that is, you could have it more often. And yeah. Thirdly, I saw that nobody was doing the right way. When I say the right way is the biryani, supposed to be dum cooked, layered biryani. And I saw that everybody, whoever was doing at that point of time, not too many people were doing biryani, but they were doing biryani in bulk, putting it in plastic containers and delivering it to your home after eating it.
Yeah.
I saw this opportunity of doing a fresh cooked dum biryani. And since I was from the industry, I took a lot of advice from chefs across the board, and they said it is not possible to do it on a commercial scale. Yes, ghar pe biwi, wife makes it, mom makes it, that's a different thing in a pot, but on a commercial scale, it is difficult to do. Probably I took it as a challenge and I quit my job, well-paying job, doing very well. I said, no, let me take it as a challenge. And I started doing a lot of R&D on this product of making a handi. I would go to a village outside Delhi called Kumar Gaon. Get a pot made, come here, try and make a biryani, it would not come out right, go back again, change the size of the pot, weight of the pot, thickness of the pot, and make all over again. It took me a while, for close to a month and a half, to actually get the handi right, pot right, and the process of making a biryani in the pot right. So that is one. Secondly, I also, being from the industry, I saw a lot of people waste and order food because they don't know the portion size of a restaurant. Some at times you either over order, you under order. So that is how the Kilo concept came up. I said, I will sell everything by weight so that people know exactly your appetite, how much you can eat. Probably half a guy like me, half a kilo is good enough for two meals. And somebody like with a good appetite can have it all by himself. But it is easier to order when you know the weight of the portion that you're buying. So that is how the whole menu was designed around the idea of having a portion by weight. And that's why the name by Kilo. When we started off, everything was multiples of kilos. A quarter kilo, half a kilo, or 1 kilo, that is how it is. And we stuck to that concept. So that is the reason of the Kilo concept. And the cuisine that we decided at that point of time was around the Nizam and Nawab cuisine. That was not talked about cuisine much, but it's a really good food that they used to do a lot of cooking, the Nawabs and Nizam. So we picked up the Nawabs and Nizam cuisine and we stuck to that concept of Nawabs and Nizam. So food from Lucknow, Hyderabad, Kolkata, where the Nawabs and Nizams act. So we have all the three styles of biryani. And till date, every order is individually cooked in a handi, freshly cooked, and the same handi is delivered to the customer's home. In fact, we also give a small chula along with every handi so they can keep it warm and serve it from the handi. So that is the basic story. We started very small, with a small kitchen in Gurgaon. I didn't have too much of money to start off. I sold my house, car, gamble everything on this concept that I had. And cloud kitchen was not a concept, by the way, that point of time. Now people talk about cloud kitchen. There was no Zomato Swiggy doing deliveries 2015. Zomato was just a discovery platform. So I listed myself on Zomato as a discovery platform, created website, online ordering platform, had my own delivery riders. And I said, since I can't afford a dine-in or a retail front-end restaurant because I don't have that amount of money, we'll do delivery format, but serve good food. That was the basic idea. Good, authentic food delivered home. That was the basic idea of doing it on our own platform. And thankfully, I think the concept took off. People started liking it. slowly over time, biryani became a category. It got listed separately on Zomato. And since I was on my own portal, people understood the delivery concept and started ordering. So that is, I think, then.
I think you've summed it up really well. And, it's an absolutely fascinating journey. You know, just on a personal anecdote, a few years ago, I was at a birthday party and the host had organized biryani, as you do at some parties. You know, it's easy to eat. It's a full meal, like you said. And soon the biryani became the center of attraction at the party. And for a group of 20-year-olds, I can tell you that it's typically the liquid attractions that have all the attention. And that was the first time I came across biryani by kilo. Now, I wanted to understand, who is the target consumer in your mind, right? Is it someone organizing a party? Is it somebody just looking for a meal? Is it a bachelor in a new city? Or do you believe you cater to everybody?
So basically, when we started off, since we had bigger portion, 1 kilo portion, so idea was, and our still tagline says, there's always a reason to celebrate. Biryani was always related to celebrations, could be a birthday, anniversary, promotion, whatever. So that was the basic idea of having bigger portions so that you can celebrate with your friends from a bigger 1 kilo handi and share with 2-3 people. That is the idea. But slowly over time, we realized a lot of people, I had bachelors calling me up and saying, sir, aapke paas to single portion nahi hai. I don't want to have a kilo of biryani. And that is how we launched a 1/2 kilo portion. Eventually also we launched a 250 gram portion, which is a single portion also. So because then people started realizing, saying that we could not have 1 kilo biryani, though like your product, we can't order as often as we want to. We only order for celebration. And we launched 1/2 kilo. So if I say the target audience is everybody, my daughter is 16 years old and she has it twice a month. Mm-hmm. She's also my target audience, which I am surprised myself that teenagers still like to have biryani. So, but I think typical target, I would say probably a 30 to 45 year old guy have been in working for the last five, eight years, has a decent salary.
Yeah.
Is somebody who there. But I think across the board, an old age 60 plus guy also would probably have a biryani youngsters. But majority falls in this bracket, I would say.
Okay.
And it is associated with celebration, but now celebrations can be anything. Mm-hmm. It is not earlier, unlike earlier, it was only birthdays and anniversary. Now yeah. You celebrate for everything.
That's true.
Is how it is.
And you know, your USP is clear. You freshly cook each biryani, the khansama style, specially aged basmati rice, spices procured from Kerala and served in the handis in which it is cooked. But I'm sure this is not the easiest operation in the world to manage. Can you talk us through some of the complexities and how you managed to overcome them?
As you rightly said, it is not easy. It sounds very easy. Otherwise, people would have done it by now. We are the only ones still now doing fresh dum cooked biryani on every order. Thanks to my background, I came from a pizza background. I have worked for Pizza Express, Pizza Corner. I was the CEO with Pizza Corner. So pizza was in my background. And I realized that pizza is the only thing that is made fresh,
yeah,
heated fresh. So made fresh on an assembly line format. So that was obviously the background that I had. And so I thought I have to make it a dumb steps that I have to have and create an authentic product using dumb steps. So that anybody with a little bit of training should be able to make the product. Otherwise, I will not be able to scale, obviously. Then I will be restricted to only one outlet with a skilled chef. So if I have to scale, I need to have a process of assembly line concept. So the biryani, so what we did, we centralized as much as possible. So the meat is the most important part in this thing. And we do our butchery ourselves, which is very complicated to do the butchery yourself. So we do the butchery ourselves, we procure the best of meat and chicken, do the butchery ourselves, clean them, cut them, freeze them, and then send it to the outlets, store them at the outlets. Rest, masalas, as you rightly said, the masalas come from Kerala. They are, the recipe of the masala is proprietary. There's salt also added to it. So the chefs at the outlet don't even add salt. Mm-hmm. So they assemble the things by a portion chart. There are app-based timers in the kitchen. You time them, you put them dumb cooking, and the product comes out exactly the same. So you've standardized the ingredients. We've standardized the assembly process. We've standardized the equipment that is required to cook the biryani. And that is how the product comes out standard.
And I can imagine that happening, say, you know, in Gurgaon, if you have a central location and multiple outlets, but now you've scaled, you know, you're in multiple locations in India. How do you ensure that this happens in various locations across North India, South India, everywhere?
So as I said, the key ingredients have been standardized, which is the meat, the masala, the fried onion, the curd. Those are the key ingredients that goes, and the rice, which is, we use the most expensive rice in the country as of now. So they have been standardized, and once the ingredients are standardized and is available across the country, logistically, that is very easy to do it for us now. Yeah. So the rest is just assembling them in the outlet and fresh dum cooking. So that is, I think, that is the code that we've been able to crack, that able to standardize the raw materials and assembly process, and it can be replicated anywhere. With 20 cities, we are doing it very successfully.
Now, all the founders that come to us on the show, they all have their unique journeys, and all their journeys are very fascinating. But yours, 2+ decades in the food industry, and you've seen every level. You've seen something at the bottom, and now, you know, you're somewhere close to the top. Even today, do you find like some of the learnings that you took from back in the day that are helping you today? How have the learnings?
Really? Very much. So I started my career as a waiter. I don't know if you know that. So I started career 28 years back as a waiter in Delhi Maharaja Sheraton Hotel. And that is where I saw the Bukhara and the Dum Pukht. I used to see Chef Qureshi cooking the biryani. And that fascinated me a lot, that how slow cooking, dum cooking, all that was there. It was obviously playing in mind. And that came out when I started and launched Biryani by Kilo. So that obviously, that is one thing that I took, which was 28 years back when I started off slow cooking and fresh dum cooking.
That's amazing.
That is one. Obviously, since I worked across designations in the industry, it helps me a lot, and I still use everything that I've picked up. So, as I gave you the example of the cuisine that I picked because of my background from where I started my career at. Over a period of time, worked in different levels. I think HR is naturally comes to me because I've worked in various levels, so I can relate to people at every level, be it a delivery boy or a UT cleaner or the guy in the kitchen. I'm able to relate to them very fast because I have been at that level at one point of time. So that works wonders for me, I would say, as an organization. And I've been able to build a culture of a family because of that, because I'm able to bring myself down to that level and relate to the guy and able to teach him or tell him how the organization how he's supposed to conduct himself in an organization. So that is the second thing that has been of great help. Yes, on the model point of view, learnings, I've seen a lot of failures, restaurants fail. Cloud Kitchen came up because I saw 10 to 15% restaurants fail because of location. Mm-hmm. You don't know you're doing well because of the mall or because people like your food and is coming to your restaurant.
Yeah. So
if you open in a mall, if you go out and open in a high street, you are constrained on metro construction happening, one-way traffic. So at times, location is not in your control. So that is how the Cloud Kitchen came up. I said, I'll sell good food, but through a Cloud Kitchen, I know that food is good. It is not location dependent. You can have it in the comfort of your home. And that is the delivery concept came up. So all these are learning. As I said, by portion, the reason we sell by kilo is the only reason. Yeah. I don't want people to waste food. Also, fresh cooking ensures that I don't waste food at my end also. Mm-hmm. In the industry, the food wastage, and I'm sure you know, since you have managed so much software, you will know, the food wastage at a restaurant is 5 to 7%. Yeah. Our restaurant wastage is close to zero because we cook on every order. We don't have to anticipate and keep food prepared. We only prepare when the order comes in. So we don't waste food. So all those things are, I think, obviously picked up from one part of my life and then been put into this model that you see in front of you.
I think that's great to hear. And that's learning for people across the board, right? There are people who become entrepreneurs very young, but there are people who become entrepreneurs later. So to anyone watching this, you know, take your learnings along the way, and you never know one day when you can kind of achieve your dream. So now correct me if I'm wrong. I know all your biryani is freshly cooked and typically takes about 80 to 90 minutes to reach the consumer at a time when everyone's obsessed with wanting the food as quickly as possible. How do you stand out? How do you ensure that the customer keeps coming back to you?
So I'll give you a small story. When I started off, the biryani was ordered 3 hours in advance. That was the time because my biryani used to take 1.5 hours to cook. The process was that, and you had to order 3 hours in advance. And I was surprised that when I used to get up in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, people would place orders for lunch. Then I was to wonder that people actually, everybody told me, India mein nobody thinks of ordering so much in advance. You will not succeed. You will not. But I realized that people will obviously understand the difference between a fresh cooked food and a reheated food. So I think that was a big conviction I had, because I have seen the difference myself when I was in my previous job, when I used to eat a food that was prepared in the commissary, which was fresh, and an outlet which was reheated or stored in fridge and then reheated and served. I said people might not be able to find out the minute differences of the rice दो साल नेचुरली एज राइस है और बेस्ट ऑफ मीट और बेस्ट ऑफ मसाला, बट दे विल बी एबल टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन अ गुड फूड एंड अ बैड फूड. आई थिंक दैट एनीबडी, यू डोंट हैव टू बी कोनेसियर टू बी एबल टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन अ गुड फूड एंड अ बैड फूड. यू माइट नॉट बी एबल टू से दैट दिस शर्ट इज एरो और दिस शर्ट इज अ 300 रुपीज शर्ट और 2000 रुपीज शर्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द फैब्रिक और द मटीरियल व्हाट दे टेक्निकली व्हाट दे हैव यूज्ड. But once you wear it, you know this is a more comfortable shirt and I like this shirt. So similar for food. So people can distinguish that. So, and also, I think over a period of time, people got educated with the fact that slow cooking is better cooking, first of all, and it is more tastier. So if you want to have good biryani, you'll have to wait for at least 30-40 minutes because it takes 30 minutes to cook the biryani now. And we deliver based on the distance that you are in between 40 to and 60 minutes. So people appreciate the fact, in fact, if by chance the food reaches a little bit early, I have complaints, customers telling me that khana jaldi kaise bhej diya, aapne pehle se bana ke rakha hoga. So that, to that extent, so I think people realize, so just to give an example, when you go to the airport, you know if it is a domestic flight, I will go an hour early, and if it is an international flight, I'll go 3 hours early. Correct. So it's a mindset that people automatically get tuned to, that this is how it is supposed to be. So I think people appreciate fresh, dumb-cooked food, and it takes a little bit of more time than usual.
And, you know, I'm not surprised that you told me that when you wake up, there were lots of orders and people thought of their meals so much in advance. Because I can tell you at home, when we eat lunch, we talk about dinner. When we eat dinner, we talk about the next day's dinner. So in India, I think food's on people's mind all the time and they're willing to wait for quality food. So I noticed that you guys are doing a lot of things to keep your customers engaged online. I think you now have a live kitchen that, you know, Sumant, Varun and I were actually looking at where people can watch the live activity from your kitchen, and a bunch of other marketing stuff. You have a brand ambassador now, you're speaking to influencers. What are some of the things that has seen good return? And
So I think there is two, three things. One, due to COVID, obviously, we were the first ones to take a lot of steps to first inform customers about the hygiene practices that we follow. And that's why we did a live kitchen that people can actually keep inside the kitchen and see how the food is being prepared, how the hygiene levels of the kitchen. We are also cognizant of the fact that the handi that we prepare in, we are not touched by hand. I think that is, so I'm just giving you the example for the COVID and then I'll come to the second part of the question. So we also realize that it's very important for customers to know that we don't touch the food. You are the one who opens the seal, and once it is dumb cooked at 250 degrees centigrade, there is no way there can be any contamination to that product. So I think we started talking about it a lot over different modes of communication, as had bloggers talk about it. All our communication was around freshness and sealed and safety. I think that was one thing that has done, I think, worked for us, first of all.
Yeah.
And when you say about, and the modes, we don't do a lot of spending on ATL. Obviously, we don't have the kind of money to spend on ATL like many others do. But we do very sensitive. So I think digital is something that we are very clear, and we see a lot of conversions happening in digital. So we focus a lot of on digital because everybody now has a smartphone or is on the laptop or a tablet. So it is easier to reach out to customers through the digital medium. Traditional medium, we have stopped using, not completely, I would say, but we don't do press ads or we don't do flyers so much. So I think we are more focused on digital, Facebook, Insta, Google. I think these are the more modes that we prefer now spending our marketing budget on. Whatever we do is the, because it is easier to track conversion, see the efficiency of every spend that you do, and we intend to probably follow that route.
Absolutely. And you know, there's one thing that's unique about your brand which I kind of wanted to tell you about while I was doing my research, that is, you guys have a very high, you know, funnel conversion rate once people come on to ordering platforms as well. So if someone's looking at Zomato, someone's looking at Swiggy, people are converting at a higher rate when they come to biryani by kilo than the others. So when you do put in money on digital marketing, I think you'll definitely see results like you mentioned.
Yes.
So it's not just about business for you guys. I read that all your handis are crafted by hand, and you know, that way you provide meaningful employment, and you have your BB Cake Cares initiative as well. How important is it that you have a socially conscious brand, and what are some of the new things you guys have done maybe over the last 12 months or so?
So first of all, BBK Cares, when we are one outlet old, I think we've been doing this. We adopted a family in the Potter's Village and gave him them work to make the handis for us. And he's now become a big man. Now we adopted, I think, 7-8 of them families because the volumes are very high. I used to go sit in their house, make handis with them, have lunch with them. So that was, I think, from day one that we have to give back to society in some form or the other. Yes, we were not very big to we do monetary contribution. It was not possible for us. But from day one, in whatever bit we could do, that is something that we've been always doing. So handi, the potter's thing is from day one, from the first handi that we made is been there. Then we came out with the concept of BBK Cares, whereby we, on a specific day of the week, there are two things, either customers can contribute and we also contribute equally and then give food to the underprivileged. And besides, with COVID, we now on a weekly basis, we pick up pockets where we go, each restaurant has to pick up one pocket and has to go and distribute food to the people who are needy at this point of time. So that is something we do on a regular basis. In fact, last year we did close to I think 5 lakh meals that we provided to underprivileged people. And we keep doing it as a regular activity. We don't talk about it much, but it is something which is a part of a regular ops routine now.
Wow, great. That's great to hear. And I hope you guys keep doing it. I'm sure it's making a difference to a lot of families out there. Now, while a lot of brands have adopted digital trends and pivoted towards delivery now, you guys actually went the other way and you launched physical outlets. So when did you decide to do this? And how does it fit into the whole business for you guys? And how tough was it to pivot from a brand known for spectacular biryanis at home to having physical outlets as well?
So our physical outlet came in 3 years later from our first delivery outlet. And first outlet was Chandigarh. So there has been 2-3 thought processes while we launched our first dine-in outlet. First of all, metros, obviously we still can't afford to do a dine-in outlet because rents don't justify. So we said we will only do dine-in at tier 2 cities and one in a metro so we wanted to have the emotional connect. So people knew that we serve good food. We also, when you go to a new city like a Chandigarh, when we went for the first time, I said people in Chandigarh might not know that we serve very good food. It's hygienic. You can go inside and look at the kitchen. Delhi people know because we had close to 10 outlets by that time when we had. So people were actually aware. So I said, if you go to a new city, it is difficult for us to communicate to a customer saying that we are a premium product. We do fresh dum cooked biryani. So we said we should have a small interface for the customer whereby he can come, sit, experience the whole thing. And then if he likes it, he goes back home and orders all over again for a home delivery food. That is how the idea came up. The first outlet was a real success in Chandigarh and still doing extremely well. And thereafter, now every tier 2 city that we go into, the first outlet, we do a small 15-20 seater seating for customers like Ranchi, Patna. We have one outlet where people can go and experience the dining experience of biryani by kilo and then go back home and order. And it has worked to everyone. It does both marketing and the experience both work together. In a smaller city, the rentals are still realistic, so it is easier for us to execute this.
Okay, that's very interesting to see how you've actually strategically thought about that, entering different cities, and great insight for everyone watching this. Now, you guys are clearly a brand with lofty ambitions and you've had the results to back it so far. Multiple rounds of funding, expansion to more cities, and constant innovation in the menu. Now, what is your target for the coming years? What can we expect from Biryani by Kilo?
So, in terms of number of outlets is the target that I can give. So, we are close to 50 outlets today. We are just 50 outlets. We signed a 50th outlet. And we intend to open close to 40 outlets by next year. Not March, I'm saying December next year. So, that is the target that we have. 40 to 50 outlets is the target for December next year. So get to 100 outlets by December next year or latest by March 23.
All right. That's great. Now, how do you guys balance the hassle of managing multiple aggregators? I know, for example, with Urban Piper, you guys are live with Swiggy, Zomato, DotPay, MagicPin, and you guys have your own channel as well to manage. Now, how do you kind of balance the two? Do you see a conflict there with having your own channel, or do you think it all exists in perfect harmony?
No, I think the own channel is a great, because we started with own channel, we didn't have aggregators when we started off, and our own channel is pretty strong also. So we get a decent amount of orders on our own channel. The reason we have our own channel, first of all, is that we feel that the product is a little bit different and premium. We want to control the doorstep experience. So the Zomato orders also we deliver ourselves. Besides Swiggy, all the orders we deliver ourselves because we want to control the doorstep experience, because our riders are trained, there is a training center, they went to go through rigorous training before being a delivery rider. So they are refresher training that happens with them. So it was important for us to do our own delivery. And that is why our own channel has been pretty strong. Yes, aggregators are important for us. People discover us through aggregators and order through aggregators. But delivery is something that we want to control end of the day. So that is how we make the balance as of now.
That's great. Just one question about cloud kitchens. I know you mentioned it a couple of times, but when was that realization that you had that Biryani by Kilo is going to be a cloud kitchen? And what do you think is in store in this booming segment in the next couple of years?
And my friend tells me, Lakshmi, bait hi thi tumhari dimag mein us time, jisme this time tumko ye idea aaya tha. So I think very coincidental that I got into the right category of biryani, right format of delivery format. And now I think that is reaping benefits as of now. Going forward, I think this is the way to be. The delivery will be a very popular mode of, and with COVID, I think it's been proven that delivery is going to remain a very strong mode of people ordering food from rather than dining. Also realize that metros are getting difficult to go out, park right. your car and have dine-in. So I think delivery will remain. So I'm very happy to have chosen this channel and see a great future for this. And also chosen the category which has no incumbent leader as of now in the country, unlike a pizza or a burger. So we see ourselves to be the leaders in coming times for sure.
Okay. Now to create a premium brand such as yours, right? Every part of the operation, it's like a jigsaw puzzle. It has to be perfectly in sync. When you think about technology and partnerships, you know, such as you are synced with Urban Piper, what are some of the use cases you are trying to solve for? What are some of the challenges that you have there?
So technology plays a very, very important role in our organization. And I'm a tech geek. So I try and put in, I probably over, so when I had one outlet also, I had an ERP from day one. I could control everything. We had a call center for one outlet with the two employees sitting and taking orders through an IVR. So I have been very clear that technology is an enabler that is going to be able to help me scale up, control the processes. And because it will be difficult to manage 20 cities. So now we have a lot of technology. Urban Piper is just one of them that helps me aggregate the orders from all the aggregators and puts it into my platform. But we have rider tracking we have taken a lot of white label applications or applications from different people, multiple of them. So we have a rider tracking application, which Domino's and we are the only ones using that application for customers can real time track the riders. We have shifting to Navision for our inventory management, Microsoft Navision for our inventory management. We have an HR ERP for all our employees have login. May mark the attendance, see their form 16, see their attendance, leave, pay slip, everything on the app. We have a doc online for all our employees. They can log in, do doctor's consultation. So we have, beside the POS, which is the heart of the, obviously the, in our industry, we have built in a lot of ancillary IT platform that has been added around that to control everything. And everything is cloud-based, easy to manage, see from one place. So that is, and going forward, we'll keep adding something or the other time and time again.
All right. Awesome, Mr. Kaushik. Now, before we let you go, we want to do a quick rapid fire with you, if that's okay.
Sure.
Okay, let's get started. External funding or bootstrap?
Bootstrap.
Your favorite item on your menu?
Kolkata mutton biryani.
Okay. Profitability or growth?
I think balance of both.
How often do you order from outside?
Once a week.
Okay. Do you have a favorite cuisine?
Yeah, Oriental.
All right. MBA or getting experience on the job?
Experience on the job.
A startup to look out for in India?
Lot of them. Difficult to name one few, and I don't think it would be fair on my part to name somebody.
Okay. Do you have a favorite movie?
Three Idiots.
All right. Favorite holiday destination?
Favorite holiday destination is Coorg.
Coorg. All right.
Yeah. I love that place.
Awesome. And last question, is there a book that influenced you or changed your life?
I don't read much. I listen to people over on YouTube and follow people, but not too. there's a quote that I follow, and I keep telling this quote to everybody because it's worked for me. So I'm bound to tell you this also. Be nice to people on your way up. Probably you'll be meeting them on your way down. When I was starting DDK, a lot of people helped me to set it up, and I was surprised because they said at one point of time you had helped us, and it was a time for us to help you. And probably that's why DDK is such a big success.
That's wonderful. Do you have any words for budding entrepreneurs out there who can really learn from your experience over multiple decades?
Yeah, sure. So one thing that I want to tell budding entrepreneurs, that you might have an idea which is brilliant, but I see people just fresh out of college and want to jump into entrepreneur. So there is a huge failure rate at being an entrepreneur. So if you are fresh out of college and trying to do something new, and if you fail, you get an early setback in your life, which obviously marks, you have a spot on your mind that this is something that has happened to me, and it will keep bothering you all your life. So I always say that please gain from some organizational discipline by working at some organization for a few years so that you know how to run an organization. You have to be jack of all trade and master of one. It's very important. So that for that, you need to have a little bit of experience to know how HR functions, how IT functions, how finance happens. And you have to be strong in one of the areas that you're passionate about, that you want to drive. So once that you have the 2-3 years of experience, you know how to run an organization, and then use your whatever dream that you have to pursue that dream. So the failure rates will be lesser, I would say.
That's great advice. Do you finally have any words about your association with Urban Piper, how the journey has been and so on?
So it's been a wonderful journey. I think we've been there with you now close to three years now. And it's been a wonderful journey. And this is the first time I realized that we don't have to pick up the phone and complain of issues. It just struck me now while talking to you that I've actually not interacted anybody, though I know Saurav and everybody, I've never had to call them up for anything. So that itself says that I think your support system is very strong. Your product is very robust. That is the best thing. It can handle peak. I remember that was my biggest requirement when I shifted, that we'd be able to, like today is Eid and there has been no issues in terms of orders flow and all. And our volumes today are phenomenal on the day of Eid. So I think there's a very robust product and a great team always available. Thank you so much for that.
Yeah, well, thank you, Mr. Kaushik, for first of all, taking your time out today on Eid. I'm sure it's a busy day, even though it's a holiday for a lot of us, for sharing your wisdom and for talking to us about Biryani Bay Kilo, the food tech industry, and much, much more. It's been an absolutely great conversation. And thank you. Keep serving great biryanis.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and leave a comment below, and subscribe to stay updated with the latest in the food tech industry with Urban Piper.